So I wanted to ask, we've talked about Innovid as an ad serving company, and that's a big part of it and has been for a number of years. Tell us about what you're doing with NBCU, some of the problems in the supply chain around OTT, what you're solving, and what that means for Innovid, and what it means for the industry more broadly.
And for the world, and for peace in the Middle East. It's... Yeah, so ad serving, and you can generalize it even more about workflow and simplify the whole process from a post-production or a creative shop creating an ad all the way to this, the viewer seeing that in his or her device. So this whole process is something that was key to Innovid success and key to Innovid the investment for a long time. And what we're seeing, obviously, with the shelter in place and overall is just the move to streaming and the move to connected television. Right now, we're north of 40% of all the different ads that Innovid delivered in the third quarter of this year was in connected television already. So that's a very, very large share of overall ads that we stream. And with connected television, there is a big, or television, honestly, there is a big demand for higher quality. Because people see when the content is pixelated, people expect that the television is a product that is just works. It doesn't buffer, there's no black screen, the volume doesn't fluctuate, it doesn't pixelate, all of those things that when you watch linear traditional television doesn't happen. So we're very excited to, what we announced is a collaboration with NBC, with the Peacock side of NBC, of rethinking that workflow to ensure higher quality for viewers. And this is what we announced and brought to market just now.
So Tal, there's so much that's rejected. We've been reading the reports, a recent article in AdExchanger, tremendous number of videos are rejected by the publisher. Was that surprising to you? And why is that number so high? What number are you finding?
Funny enough, it's clearly not surprising because we're in the heart of it for many, many years, and we've been screaming from the roof that it looks like digital everything is easy, but it's definitely not. This is numbers reported by NBC. Those numbers are kind of an industry average. As many publishers, definitely the one that adhere to higher quality would reject content for our ads. For many, many reasons. By the way, there is a misunderstanding that it's not only because the ad is to a lower quality or the volume is too low or too high or this is pixelated, it doesn't matter. An ad could be rejected for so many different reasons. There's tracking pixels from vendors that are not allowed. There's the potential for user data leakage or many other things, or the format of the ad is not the right format and it does not apply to every device, for example. So there's many reasons for that reject. The number NBC quoted is almost 40% of the ads that reach NBC are being rejected and then returned back to the advertiser, which creates a lot of delay and problems in the campaign. So this is, if you can think about it by numbers, this is, we're talking about 8 out of every 20 ads. So every 20 ads that are running, 8 of them are being rejected. We, together with NBC and Peacock team, want to lift this number all the way to 1 out of 20. So to move to 95% success of ads that delivered. And we're doing that because, again, this is not rocket science. We're just integrating the software. So then the marketer or the creative agency will see all the different elements that NBC asked for all the way in the second that they upload the creative. And that's and with that capability, we're essentially limiting the rejects that are down the line. If you think about it, this is kind of zooming out. If you think about it, all the what is called the kind of the closed platform, NBC, Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, TikTok, anyone, any of the platforms that have a UI that manage the end to end, are very easy to prevent those problems because you log into Facebook Business Manager, upload a video, and Facebook knows exactly what are the checks and balances they need to do, so they can alert at the second of the upload. The overall open internet industry has a lot of different vendors, a DSP, an ad server, maybe multiple ad servers, the VAS provider, SSAI provider. There's many pieces in the chain, and it's very hard to enforce the exact same quality as the closed system. What we're trying to do with NBC is essentially do the same thing as YouTube or Instagram or others. So you'll use software to make the feeling that this is super button up without the limitation of a closed ecosystem. So you get both best of both worlds.
So tell us a little bit about where this platform, this tool that you're using could be used perhaps by other programmers, others in the industry, what a roadmap looks like. And tell us a little bit about sort of the broader Innovid ad serving plan evolution. I know it's a big part of your business. We don't talk about it that much. So kind of Sure. Give us the bigger picture here.
Sure. So I'm going to start with our collaboration with Peacock and where does it go from here? Frankly, and we said it so many times, this is not for the for the nice statement. This is just the beginning. What we did right now is a piece of supply chain optimization. There's many layers on top of that. For example, now you want to bring personalization. So you want to not only make the ad flow easily, but you want to make sure that Andy would get an ad and myself would get an ad, or Ryan or five other people would get different ads to the right quality. Then the supply chain becomes even more complicated. So all of those things are adding more problems. So what we did is we started with that integration. In their attempt, once you have software to software and not people, you can now build on it and create new capabilities. And clearly, our attempt did not stop there. It's amazing to innovate with Peacock and to rethink of how those processes work. But we want to bring it everywhere. We want to allow any marketers assume and believe that they would get the highest quality through their creative. And frankly, we think a lot on the viewer. We want every viewer that watches streaming to have the same feeling of beautiful television as it is on the traditional side. So this is on where we go from here. So adding personalization, adding more capabilities, and really focusing on the higher quality and raising the bar as we can. So that's on that side. On the Innovid roadmap, so ad serving. We always looked at ad serving as a means to an end. So think about it as a delivery network, almost like a FedEx that has the ability to take packages from one end to another. But now, once we have a fully robust network, we can build on top of that. So one is what we said about personalization. We're doubling down a lot on that. Just recently, shameless plug, we were called as a leader innovator by Forrester in creative ad tech, which is essentially, how do you make that ad or that creative better? Use technology to make the creative better. And then on the other side, once we own the network and it's, again, all software-based, we can apply very, very good measurement. Anything from we know exactly what a given household is watching, so we can make sure that you will not watch the exact same creative when you jump between programmers because we map that individual household. If we zoom further out, an area that I can say that I'm focusing a lot and a lot of us at Innovid are thinking so much about and believe that 2021, it will be in the heart of everything that companies in the CTV space are working on is around identity. Is how do you make sure that we treat the internet in a respectful and a privacy safe way and bring all the capability that I just mentioned? Personalization, lower frequency, capping of the media, and at the same time, make sure that we're not doing one-to-one tracking, there's no potential for data leakage, or data brokers do not get access to data that they don't need. All of those things are areas that we're investing so much on, specifically in the world of connected television that right now doesn't really have a good identity.
Tal, and also just tell us a little bit about, you know, the you referenced Forrester, your recognition in the creative space, and that's certainly you've been at it in terms of interactive ad units, and tell us sort of where that stands with Innovid and industry adoption more broadly.
Sure. So first of all, the Forrester report and the way that we look at it, interactivism is a technology. This is not the product. The user doesn't care if it's interactive, again, for the sake of being to interact. Those are there are different tools in a toolbox to increase engagement and to increase favorability of a brand and just something cooler for a viewer. So again, personalization, taking the same ad and making sure that you will see the right one that matters to you and not the one that matters to your neighbor or to a different age group or things like that. That's a tool to make a better personalization. Interactivity is another one. Different shoppable capability. Second screen is another area we invest a lot. Is how do you focus on activities like shopping that you're probably not going to do on the main screen. You want to add to cart and then continue checkout later, or other things like that. So we have different different capabilities like that. To your question about adoption, we get a lot of adoption of that, specifically in the CTV space. Again, when the canvas is bigger, when people are giving better attention to the content that they watch, and you have better, more pixels and bigger canvas and more beautiful screen to introduce more more creative, then you can do things that that get better results. And we proof is in the pudding. We're seeing that all along. We have very big partnership with many large broadcasters with Roku or with Hulu, with Fox, with NBC, with others, all to dial up better ad creative across the board. And we believe that coming beginning of next year, we'll see even new things coming up that we're cooking right now, all around, again, this idea of once you have this very robust network that could do seamless delivery at the higher quality possible, now you can think about how do you make the best payload or the best ad to be delivered. So stay tuned.